All we are asking is here is to hear us out. And they don't even allow that. So, well, kung ganun, para ako as an individual, as a Filipino citizen, right now, I feel oppressed sa ginagawa nila. We will insist our constitutional right to express ourselves. It's freedom of speech lang naman. Yun lang naman talaga ang hinihingi natin. Hindi mo naman pwede the pagsabihan yung isang individual to tell somebody to shut up. Because that is very undemocratic pag ginawa mo. It's not really na may gusto kaming pabagsakin o gano'n. All we are asking is to hear us out. And they don't even allow that. So, well, kung gano'n, para ako as an individual, as a Filipino citizen, right now, I feel oppressed sa makanta ginagawa nila. Yan yung ano eh. It already happened. It happened in Bulacan, in Bustos. Una dyan sana sa Malolos. Then, may revoke yung permit. I do not know kung bakit. Tapos sa Bustos, everybody was there. Nandyan na. And there were rumors na yung property owner hindi pina may pumunta daw para pagsabihan na pigilan yung or not to let him use the property for the funeral. So it was rumors, you know, like, I do not have any evidence of that, but yun yung nangyari.
Last question na lang. Habang lang maisog sa mga nangyayaring ito, hindi ba, it won't stop from doing habang maisog to really, you know, air your
sentiments? Yes, of course. Kasi we will insist our constitutional right to express ourselves. It's freedom of speech lang naman. Yun lang naman talaga ang hinihingi natin. Kasi kung hindi mabigay yan, it's a simple right actually. Magsabi ka lang kung how you feel about, you know, sa mga nangyayari ngayon. And I do believe that there is nothing wrong with it. Wala namang mali dyan. Hindi mo naman pwede pagsabihan yung isang individual tell somebody to shut up. Because that is very undemocratic pag ginawa mo.
Thank you, Mayor.
Sir, do you expect that this is Leyte ang tatlo pang isang business as Marcos or Marcos country? Do you expect this kind of treatment? Anticipating niyo yun?
I believe so. Kasi our sentiments are inclined towards kung ano yung sitwasyon ng country nyo, and they are the ones who are in the administration. So yes, probably kung may mga movements or actions na that made us hard, made it hard for us to come here, to get here, probably, you know, like, I do not want to jump to conclusions.
Sinabi ni Presidente Duterte during his post na he's even willing to sacrifice his own life. Mm. I-continue lang ito, sir. Do you agree with that?
Well, that's his choice. Ako, hindi siguro muna kasi 36 years old pa ako. Siya yun. But, you know, like I said, during the Leaders Forum back in Davao, back in January, when I, you know, nagsalita na ako, if you go back to that forum, listen to my speech, sinabi ko naman, handa na ako, I'm ready to die. Kasi this is a press conference. It would be better for me to express, you know, how I really feel kung sana may entablado where everybody is there. But if it's for the country, then why not? Then, you know, I will be absently raising proud children. Kung yung nana mo, ilabtan ko nila. So, we'll see. Pero, this is something na hindi ko kaya na kayaan lang. It's just really simple. You just have to let us, you know, talk. Like everybody else did before this administration, it has always been a practice in the Philippines. Kung may sentiments tayo, nagsasalita naman yung mga tao. So, ngayon, bakit hindi? It really is very frustrating and oppressive. I will reiterate that it's a very oppressive demonstration by this administration.
The last time, sir, you called for the president to step down. Do we expect sana na you also see the same things here in Tacloban?
I want to clarify this. Ang inyo na ko, I will say it in Bisaya, kung wala kay gugma, kung wala kay daluoy sa mga tao, naog na lang. I never asked him to actually really do that. I said, boom.
Mayor, good morning. SMNI, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, sinabi po ni President BBM na wala rong nagawa Duterte administration sa Yolanda. But you're even here, sir. Before ka nag-mayor, nag-akot ka mga hinabang. Tabang ka sa relief efforts. Your father was first here before anything else.
I do not know. It's, you know, like, it's always been like that. I not really, but, you know, with the recent mga pangyayari, mga issues sa bansa, first, he was pointing a finger at my father na may secret agreement daw sa
China.
With China. And now, kung sino yung nanunuro, yun pala yung may problema ngayon. They have a may questionable action sila within the DND. So ngayon, ito na naman, inulit naman ng President. Sinasabi niya, parang I cannot understand why you have to make up stories when you really have all the resources and the position, you know, to really actually give a valid proposition for a debate. Manuro ka lang, wala yung ginawa. It's not becoming of a President.
So, can we say, sir, that he is a liar?
Probably. Yeah, you know, like, just watch him and, you know, let your senses tell you. Maybe the answer for me. Pero yun na nga, nanunuro. Pwede ka naman sayang lang yung oras mo dyan, kung gano'n na yun, kaya mo gawin.
Sir, good morning.